ever since we watched the Avengers saga, we always wanted to play a game with our favorite Avengers, but we only had Marvel's Spider-Man to play with. But now finally, Crystal Dynamics brought Marvel's Avengers. But there might be some issues with it. Marvel's Avengers beta, which arrived last weekend on PS4, was a really good way to get to know about the game. The game has campaign mission, and it's a perfect way to introduce every single Avenger using that bridge sequence, get to know their skill set and how they play. After this, we moved to Kamala and Hulk, and immediately I got The Last of Us vibes, since Bruce is played by Troy Baker, and you can't stop but get the feeling of Last of Us, because in here, he somehow acts as if he is playing a fatherly figure. One of the best things in the campaign was you playing as Hulk and going against Abomination. We also saw something like this in Incredible Hulk movie, but here it was so much better. We were smashing each other all the time, and this right here is why I fell in love with Hulk. The campaign missions really showed where the game shines, because it has now made me excited to play the whole campaign. It brings an interest in you to know what is going to happen in the next phase of the campaign. How is the team going to come back together?
Steve, can you hear me? Get the hell out of there!
Straight after the campaign, we are moved into the multiplayer co-op modes, and one of them is Harm Room, which is definitely the best place to practice your moves with any hero. There are waves of enemy that comes by, and that helps you get to know even more about how your character is gonna play. Not only that, you can also test out any skills that you just unlocked and also practice team play. In these multiplayer modes, you can enable matchmaking where others can join you, or you can invite your friends. However, I was never able to join any match. The moment someone joined my team, I was kicked out with a message, unable to join. And if someone did join and I wasn't kicked out, I couldn't launch the mission because it kept saying that someone is trying to join the game. And no matter how long I wait, there was no one joining. So in the beta, it was extremely hard to play with someone, and I only had the opportunity to play with one player. So matchmaking is definitely something they need to update. Also, when someone joins, you have to make sure that you select your hero as quick as possible, because in a team you can only play one hero. So if you wanted to play Iron Man and someone else has selected it, then you will have to select someone else. In my case, I had to select Hulk because he was the only one available and I don't play good as Hulk. He's very hard to control. You can also play without matchmaking, where your AI will join the match, and those AI will be your hero only. If you have an Iron Man and Black Widow in level 6 and let's say Hulk in level 2, then they will be the ones who will be joining your team, and your AI in the team, they are really good. Speaking of playing co-op modes, you get Warzone and Drop Zones. War zones are like bigger maps where you can travel from one point to another and take down outposts for gear and some loot, and then go into the primary objective where you will get a number of enemies, and you will also have to either destroy something or let Jarvis hack into something. As you move into the last stage of War Zone, it gets really chaotic and it's really fun to play. Drop zones are like War Zones but smaller, where you will have to take on a horde of enemies and you either have to kill someone or destroy something. Again, similar to that of War Zone. Now in all these modes, the gameplay side of things are really amazing. You really get to enjoy every single hero the way you want it to. It's fun jumping around, using different abilities that each hero has, and things can also be difficult if you can increase the difficulty level. But there was one big issue: it lags a hell lot. When there are lots of enemies around you, the game lags heavily, especially in PS4 Slim. Can't say the same in PS4 Pro, but it does lag for me a lot. If there are less enemies, then it's all good and probably around 30 FPS, but it sometimes go below 25 or even 20 at times. This is something they definitely need to fix because it's really annoying. Another annoying factor, in my opinion, is the co-op itself, because it's very linear. There's nothing more to it, because as I said, you either have to destroy certain something or let Jarvis hack into certain something. That's pretty much it. However, it's a great way to invite your friends and play as Avengers and bring chaos. Well, one thing I'm really happy about is gears and skills. You can earn skill points and unlock skills and try them out in Harm Rooms. And you can even unlock gears based on how much you can scavenge in these co-op modes or even campaigns. However, these gears are invisible. Like, you will see an armor type of gear, but it isn't visible. So that's a letdown, because a lot of people do want to see visible gear change or upgrades that they're doing to each superhero, which you just cannot see here. Although it does increase the strength and various other factors that is mentioned on the top. Let me talk about the characters because every single character plays brilliantly. My favorite hero to play in this game is Black Widow because first of all, she looks so beautiful. Just wanted to get that out there. And second, she is a ground character, meaning she doesn't fly, she doesn't jump like Hulk, and so it's really cool to fight with her combos. Iron Man would be my second favorite because why not? You get to fly, hover, and shoot at the same time and do all the moves that you see in the movies. Now all of these characters have two different abilities and one ultimate or hero ability. For Iron Man, it's being Hulk Buster. For Hulk, it's Hulk Smash. For Black Widow, she has this new electric rod. As I said, it's really fun to play with these characters, always using different abilities and techniques, and it's literal chaos when you guys all fight together with a number of enemies.
Prize? Ooh, cocky. I like that.
Overall, I would say Marvel's Avenger is a really good game. There are some serious issues like lags and matchmaking, and also issues like not having enough content in multiplayer co-op. But in terms of single player, I can't really wait to see what will happen. With guys such as Nolan North, Troy Baker, Laura Bailey, aka Last of Us and Last of Us 2 voice actors, Jeff Skine, who played in Resident Evil 3 Remake and The Walking Dead game, the voice acting had to be amazing, and I'm pretty much sure the story will be as well. The game does have promise, but it does need more invitational factor to let people try out other modes as well. However, the most important thing that is gameplay, in my opinion, is actually really solid, if you take the lags out. If you want to try out Marvel's Avenger, well, there will be an open beta for PlayStation 4 this very weekend and also an open beta for PC next weekend, that is August 21st to 23rd. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Make sure to smash that like button and also comment down below and share it with your friends so that they can know about Marvel's Avengers as well. My name is Given Madness and I'll see you guys in another video.